Welcome dear students. Devrako, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Okay, thank you. Devrako, already published your syllabus. Accountancy and business studies. Okay. Okay, thank you. Today I am now taking a class BST. Chapter is Internal Trade. Advantage of international trade.
Board is not visible.
Yes.
Board is visible, sir.
Huh?
Board is not visible.
Board is not visible.
Yes, sir.
Clear?
No, sir. Not visible.
Not visible?
No, sir.
International business. Now board is visible?
No, sir.
No, sir. Okay. Now it is your problem. It is not my. This is not my problem. Previous class already discussed. Export trade, procedure of export trade. Okay.
Sir, commerce book, 11 commerce books. Taking to Bolu, PM's of Delhi, projector to Bolu.
Hello, Devrako. Devrako. Now, right now, project on class 11, economics.
Okay, sir, writing.
Okay. Topic mean. Topic mean. কাউকে ডাকো তো, বোর্ড ইজ নট ভিজিবল বলছে, তাহলে বোর্ডে লিখে দিতাম, দেখি ক্লিয়ার দেখাচ্ছে তো, বোর্ড ইজ নট দেবো, বোর্ড ইজ ভিজিবল,
নো স্যার,
নো স্যার, টপিক মিন, ওকে রাইট নাও, নাম্বার ওয়ান ইন্ট্রোডাকশন, নাম্বার টু ডেফিনেশন, নাম্বার থ্রি ইম্পর্টেন্স অফ মিন, নাম্বার ফোর মিন ফর আনগ্রুপ ডাটা, মিন ফর আনগ্রুপ ডাটা, আনগ্রুপ ডাটা অ্যান্ড টাইপস অফ মিন উইথ এক্সাম্পল, মিন ফর আনগ্রুপ ডাটা অ্যান্ড টাইপস অফ মিন উইথ এক্সাম্পলস, নাম্বার ফাইভ এরিথমেটিক মিন ক্যালকুলেটেড, এরিথমেটিক মিন ক্যালকুলেটেড মেথডস, এরিথমেটিক মিন ক্যালকুলেটেড মেথডস ফর গ্রুপ ডাটা, নাও বোর্ড ইজ ভিজিবল, নট এ ফুল বোর্ড, অনলি বিএমএস লোগো, লোগো তুমি ওখানে তোমার সেটিং চেঞ্জ করো, তোমার সেটিং কিছু গন্ডগোল আছে, ইট ইজ ইউর প্রবলেম, ওকে মিন উইথ এক্সাম্পল, নাম্বার ফাইভ এরিথমেটিক মিন ক্যালকুলেট, এরিথমেটিক মিন ক্যালকুলেটেড মেথড ফর গ্রুপ ডাটা, এরিথমেটিক মিন ক্যালকুলেটেড মেথড ফর গ্রুপ ডাটা, নাম্বার সিক্স এক্সাম্পল অফ এএম, নাম্বার সেভেন ওয়েটেড মিন অ্যান্ড কম্বাইন্ড মিন, ওয়েটেড মিন অ্যান্ড কম্বাইন্ড মিন, ওয়েটেড মিন অ্যান্ড কম্বাইন্ড মিন, নেক্সট রিয়েল লাইফ এক্সাম্পল অফ মিন, রিয়েল লাইফ এক্সাম্পল অফ মিন, নেক্সট নাম্বার নাইন কনক্লুশন, নাম্বার টেন অ্যাকনোলেজমেন্ট, নাম্বার ইলেভেন বিবলিওগ্রাফি, ওকে
স্যার ওয়ার্ড লিমিট,
হ্যাঁ ওয়ার্ড লিমিট, নো ওয়ার্ড লিমিট, মিনিমাম 30 পেজেস,
ওকে
25 to 30 pages, ওকে নাও দিস মেসেজ, নাও ইউ কনভে, ওকে অল ইউর স্টুডেন্ট, অল ইউর স্টুডেন্ট ইন ক্লাস ইলেভেন, ওকে ইলেভেন কমার্স, হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ, ওকে থ্যাংক ইউ, ওকে ওকে থ্যাংক ইউ, নাও টুডে ইজ নাও ক্লাস ইম্পোর্ট ট্রেড, ওকে ইট রেফার্স টু বাইং, ইট রেফার্স টু বাইং অফ গুডস অ্যান্ড সার্ভিসেস, ইট রেফার্স টু বাইং অফ গুডস অ্যান্ড সার্ভিসেস বাই এ ফার্ম অফ হোম কান্ট্রি ফ্রম এ ফার্ম অফ ফরেন কান্ট্রি, from a firm or foreign country, it refers to buying goods and services by a firm of home country from a firm of foreign country, for example purchase of goods by an Indian firm, for example purchase of goods by an Indian firm from a Korean firm, for example purchase of goods by an Indian firm from a Korean firm, the domestic purchase of goods is referred to, the domestic purchase of goods is referred to as an importer, and the overseas based and the overseas based seller is referred to as an exporter. The domestic purchase of goods is referred to as an importer, and the overseas based seller is referred to as an exporter. Now, objective of import trade. Number one, to improve standard of living. Imports enable consumers in the home country to enjoy a wide variety of products of high quality, which enhances their standard of living. Imports enable consumer to the home country to enjoy a wide variety of products of high quality, which enhances their standard of living. Number two, to speed up industrialization. Developing countries import scarce raw materials and capitals, import raw materials and capitals goods and advanced technology required for rapid industrial development. Developing countries import scarce raw materials and capital goods and advanced technology required for rapid industrial development. Number three, to meet consumer demand. The goods which are in demand but not available in the country are imported. The goods which are in demand but not available in the country are imported. Goods in short supply are also imported to make up differences. Goods in short supply are also imported to make up deficiencies. Number four, to ensure national defense. Countries like India import defense equipment for its armed force. Countries like India import defense equipment for its armed force. Such imports enable the country to ensure the sovereignty and territorial dignity. Countries that like India import defense equipment for its armed force. Such imports enable the country to ensure the sovereignty and territorial integrity. Number five, to overcome famine. During famine, a country imports food grains and other essential commodities, to prevent starvation, drought, flood, earthquake, and other natural calamities might create famine. During famine, a country imports food grains and other essential commodities to prevent drought, flood, earthquake, and other natural calamities might create famine. Procedure of import trade. Trade inquiry. The first stage is an import transition. The first stage of import transition is to conduct inquiry and collect information about the countries and firms which can export the required goods. Importer can get such information from the trade directors, trade association, and organization after identifying a suitable exporter. The importer sends a trade inquiry. Trade inquiry is a written request from the inspector to the exporter to provide information regarding the price, terms and condition, on which the exporter will be able to supply the goods. Next, in response to the inquiry, the exporter sends a reply in the form of a quotation known as Buffon invoice. in response to the inquiry, the exporter sends a reply in the form of a quotation known as pro forma invoice. Next, the pro forma invoice contains detailed information. The pro forma invoice contains detailed information regarding price, quality, size, grade, weight, and all other relevant conditions regarding sale. All other relevant conditions regarding sales. The pro forma invoice contains detailed information regarding price, quality, size, grade, weight, and all other relevant conditions regarding sale. Now, number two, procurement of import license. In India, certain goods can be imported fairly, which for others it is compulsory for obtain import license. Importer can consult Exim, export import, Exim, export import, export import. Importer can counsel Exim export import policy to know whether license is needed or not. In case the license is mandatory for the given goods, then the importer must obtain increase from the licensing authority, obtaining foreign exchange. After obtaining license, every importer has to procure foreign exchange. Has to procure foreign exchange as payment for imports has to be made in the currency of exporting country. In India, all foreign exchange transactions are regulated and sanctioned by the Exchange Control Department of RBI. In India, all foreign exchange transactions are regulated and sanctioned by the Exchange Control Department of RBI. To obtain the sanction for release of foreign currency, importer has to submit an application to a bank authorized by RBI along with the copy of import license. If the application meets the approval of RBI, the necessary amount of foreign exchange is released through the importer's bank. Number four, placing order or indent. After obtaining the import license, the importer places an import order or indent with the exporter for supply the specific products. After obtaining the import license, the importer places an import order or indent with the exporter for the supply of specific products. Number five, obtaining letter of credit. If the payment terms between the importer and the overseas suppliers are accepted by both the parties, then the importer should obtain the letter of credit from its bank and forward it to the overseas supplier. Number six, arranging the finance. The importer should make arrangement in advance to pay. The importer should make arrangement in advance to pay to the exporter on arrival of goods at the port. Advance planning for financing imports is necessary so as to avoid huge penalties on the imported goods, huge penalties of imported goods lying uncleared as the port for wants of payment. The importer should make arrangement in advance to pay the exporter on arrival of goods at the port. Advance planning for financing imports is necessary so as to avoid the huge penalties on the importer's goods lying understand the port of the wanted. Next, receipt of shipment advice. Either loading the goods on the vessel, the overseas suppliers dispatch the shipment advice to the importer. A shipment advice contains information about the shipment goods. A shipment advice contains information about the shipment of goods. About the shipment of goods. Next arrival of goods. When the goods arrive in the importer's country, the person in charge of the carrier, ship or airway, informs the officer in charge of the books of airport about the arrival of goods. He provides the document is known as Import General Manifest. This document contains the details of the imported goods. On the basis of the document, goods on the unloaded from the carrier. Next, customs clearance and release of goods. All the goods imported into the India have to pass through customs clearance after they cross the Indian borders. Firstly, the firm has to obtain a delivery order, pay dock dues, and obtain port trust. Due to receive the firm is then required to bill entry for assessment of customs duty. After the payment of customs duty, the bill has to be presented to dock superintendent for examination. Upon his satisfaction, the bill will be presented to the port authority, who will issue the release order to the goods and receiving the necessary charges. Okay, thank you. Today is now in my class. Now see the next class for Somo sir. Okay, thank you.